So once again, welcome back. So we are going to continue with the same chapter number 4, animals, food and feeding habits, right? So there I'm just going to review what all we had learned. We had learned about herbivorous animals, carnivorous animals, omnivorous animals, and before that also I had explained you who all come under animal kingdom, isn't it? I had explained you all that. So you must have understood that. Now let me explain you about food chain. Okay, what do you understand by food chain? Now food chain is, now say for example, I'll give you one example. Now if you say that I don't want to eat a plant, because plants are producers, because plants should be there. If there are no plants, then there is nothing, no life on the earth, right? Because we get oxygen from them, and everyone directly or indirectly are dependent on plants, right? Now suppose you say, no, I don't want to take plants, I'll just have egg or I'll just have chicken, that's all. Well, then you must remember, if you say, okay, I'll just have egg, who gives us egg? Who lays egg? Hen. Okay, now you just want to have chicken, right? So you said, yes, I'll just have chicken, I'm not eating any plants, so you have taken chicken. But do you know what is the food of the chicken? What is that? That's plants, grains, and grains comes from the plants. That means you are taking plants indirectly. You hold your nose directly here, or you hold your nose like this, it's the same. In the same way, all of us, we have to totally dependent upon the plants. Now for example, the grains will be eaten by the chicken, and then human beings, we eat the chicken. So this is called a food chain. What is this? Food chain. The other example I'll give you, that insects are eaten by frog. Okay, and what is the food of insects? They are dependent on the plants, right? So plants are eaten by the insects, and insects eaten by the frog, and frog is eaten by the snake. And then who eats snake? Mongoose, right? So this is also a food chain. But three food chain, since you are in class 3, you should remember. Plants eaten by goat, okay? And goat is eaten by any animal or a human being. So this is called a food chain. So is it clear to you? Okay, right. Now we are coming to feeding habits of animals. Now feeding habits, how do they take their food, right? So now I've taken the example of elephant. So you know what is an elephant? It's a wild animal, isn't it? And in summer, especially in Kerala, and these elephants are kept as a domestic animal because it helps them to carry big logs and all. And have you seen them carrying the logs? Logs means the trunk of the huge trees, and where many people, they cannot lift, but then the elephant can easily, you know, lift that log with the help of its trunk. So its trunk, they use it to lift the log. And the other work of the trunk of an elephant is to cut or to break the branches, and then he takes their branches full of leaves to its mouth and it has. So that is his feeding habits, right? So in the same way, we have butterfly. Okay, now butterfly, what do they do? They suck nectar. And now, one more thing. This elephant, they have trunk. So I told you, they use number one to carry the logs. Number two, it breaks the branches and then takes it to its mouth. And then he takes that, he eats that grass, the leaves or grass, whatever, it comes under plants. Now, the third one, with the help of its trunk, takes the water from the trunk. It takes the water, it sucks through its trunk. So three advantages elephant has with its trunk. Now trunk with that long nose and hand. Now butterfly, if you talk about butterfly, what is the food of the butterfly? Nectar. And what is nectar? Nectar is the sweet juice. the flowers they produce. So you must have seen beautiful butterflies sitting on the flowers. Why? To suck the nectar, and from the nectar we get what? Honey, isn't it? Now, the other one is, for example, leech and mosquito, what do they suck? They suck blood. You know, leech, during rainy season we get long leeches, right? So leeches, and then you see mosquitoes, and if you kill that mosquito, you see the blood comes out. So where do we get the blood? Got the blood from our body. Okay, so here I explain you how elephants takes its food, how butterfly takes, and how leech and mosquitoes. Right, now I like to explain you the other thing, tree the curd. Now under this heading I'll explain you what you understand by tree the curd. Now tree the curd means, you must have noticed cows and buffaloes, they go to the field in the morning, in the afternoon, or even if they are kept at home, they are given the grass and hay, right? So they just eat that first, right? Then afterwards, you must have seen in the evening time, they are sitting, but they are always moving their mouth, is that right? So what is happening? That is, like all these animals, comes under tree the curd, and here I am giving an example of cows and buffaloes. They eat the grass, and towards evening later they bring, now that grass has already entered their stomach, then again they bring back the food which they have taken inside, then slowly they chew that. And with the help of their molars, that are broad and strong, they grind their grass and chew it properly. So this animal who are in a position, they can do that they can bring, they eat the food, and again they bring it back, and then they chew. So that process is called chewing the curd. Now, the other one, we have rabbits and squirrels. I told you yesterday, rabbits are very playful, right? So some of the people, they keep them as pets. Now, squirrels also, you know. So these animals, they nibble the nuts, okay? And so nibble means they just, with their front, they just break it into small pieces. And after that, what they do? They nibble, and then with their molars, again the broad stick, they grind that. They grind that, and that is called gnawing. Here G-N-A-W-R-N-G, it is not G. G is silent here. Gnawing, okay? So they gnaw that food which they have eaten. Okay, now another example I have given, giraffe. You have seen giraffe, it has a very long neck. So that is an advantage. Giraffe can eat the leaves which are on the top of the trees very easily. With the help of the long neck, they can bite the or they can break the branches and eat the leaves. Especially very small, tiny leaves also, they can easily eat that. Okay, so now I have explained you about food chain, because this one we had already done yesterday in the previous video. Then I explained you about what exactly is food chain, their feeding habits of animals. So I explained you about elephant, I explained you about butterfly, I explained you about how leech and mosquitoes, they suck, then what do you understand by chewing the curd. So, and then I explained you about rabbits and squirrels, how they nibble and break that down into small pieces, okay, and then they chew that, and that also is called gnawing. And giraffe, I explained you just now, that because they have the advantage of having a long neck, they can eat the leaves which are at the top also. So animals without it. Now I explain you that the animals, different animals, they have different way of eating food. And so we were talking about different kinds of tail. But then what about the animals who doesn't have tail? Isn't it? So here, now, animals without tail. So animals who don't have tail, how will they have food? They also have to take food. So now here, animals are like snake, frog, lizard, chameleon. Chameleon is the kind of a lizard which changes its colors. It's camouflage probably when it wants to protect itself from the enemies, and suppose it's on the tree, it changes color to green, sometimes soil color. So we call it chameleon. Now, then here, see, what they do? They swallow the food. What they do? They swallow. Sometimes they swallow even the small animals also. And even eggs they can swallow. They don't need the tail. Right? Now here, for example, we have a frog. And frog, they have what kind of tongue? They have the lizard and frog. They have sticky tongue. Do they have? They have sticky tongue. And our tongue is, the back portion is attached and only the front portion is free. But in case of these animals, their the back portion is free and the front portion is attached. So what they do, they sit very quietly. They sit very quietly, and when they see any insect, they just dart. That means they throw their tongue. And since their tongue is very sticky, so that insect will stick to it. Stick to its tongue, and then they roll it back. They roll it back, and then this way they swallow that insect, right? So this is the way how frog and other animals, some of them, they have the food. Right, now this everything we have done since we're in class 3 in detail, when you have to study about it, you have, when you're in class 4, 5, 6, then you are going to study. Now, protection and care of animals. That means we have to, we protect ourselves in the same way, even the animals, they need the protection, they need the care. So we have two kinds of animals. One is wild animal and one is a domestic animal. Wild animals, you know from upper KG, you've been learning animals, those who stay in jungle. So we call them wild animals. And then domestic, some animals which we keep for our benefit, we keep them, right? So they give us milk, they give us meat, they give us food. So these kind of animals, we keep them as domestic animals. Because some animals, yeah, they don't help us, of course, in a way they help us, like we keep them as a pet. Like the rabbit is very playful, we want to keep them, we keep dog, it guards our house. So now you are just keeping those animals with them, and how are you going to protect them? Now suppose we have to read about care of wild animals. How are you going to? You are so scared of the wild animals. How are you going to protect them? How we protect them is that we should see that we don't kill these wild animals. These hunters, they go and they kill the animals. Some to get their skin, some they hunt them for the tusk, and some they hunt them for the horn, like rhino. And so, this is not good. It's not good, isn't it? So, if we'll kill all these animals, then what will happen? They will not, you not see any more animals. They'll keep on decreasing. Decreasing means they become less, less, less. So, and then the other thing we have to see about the wild animals, that we don't cut the jungles, because their home is jungle, no? So if you cut them, if you cut the trees, then what will happen? All the animals, they will be without the house. And then what will you see? You will see them coming to the town and cities, isn't it? And that is very dangerous. So this way we have to protect the wild animals. That is why government also, that comes under conservation. Now here, about domestic animals. Domestic animals, the animals which we keep them in the house. How do you care them? Now suppose you have a dog or you have a cat. So you have to give them food at proper time. Good food. You have to give them clean water. And wherever you are serving them, that has to be washed properly, isn't it? And where do they live? You, if you have made a kennel for the dog, then you have to see that it has to be cleaned regularly. Otherwise, they will also fall sick, isn't it? Then cows, we keep them in the shed. Horses, we keep them in stable. So all that has to be clean. Otherwise, they will fall sick. Now suppose they have fallen sick. Now in spite of this also, if animals, they fall sick, then when you have to take them, you will leave them like that? No. When you fall sick, you go to the hospital. The doctor is sick. So in the same way, when the animals, when they fall sick, then we have a hospital, we call it a veterinary hospital. And the doctor who treats the sick animals is called a veterinary doctor. So you must take them, you must look after your pet animals and animal, domestic animals, isn't it? So this all you have in the chapter number 4, animals, food and feeding habits. So now your chapter is over. Neeru ma'am is going to give you the home assignment. Make sure that when you do your work, when she sends you the assignment, you must write down the date. You must write down the date and then she's going to do the correction. Make sure that you upload your home assignment only after 5:30. Okay, and the next video, Neeru ma'am will take. Okay then, bye-bye, take care.